walk into any electronic gadget shop like this Sharper Image store in Palo Alto, California, and you're going to find gadgets that talk.
Please speak more slowly.
Gadgets that can listen, and gadgets that do both. This is the voice organizer. Now, if you're used to using something like a Sharp Wizard, you know you enter data using a keyboard or perhaps a pen. With the voice organizer, you enter data using your voice. Suppose I want to find a phone number, for example. I just say, Bill Gates. And there's his phone number. That's not really his phone number, by the way. From voice-activated organizers to talking translators, voice recognition and speech output are coming to handheld devices and desktop computers. Today, we're going to take a look at and to listen to talking computers on this edition of the Computer Chronicles. Welcome to the Computer Chronicles. I'm Stuart Chaffee. With me today is Robert Hayes, president of Psylogic, and they're developers of Voice User for Windows. Now, Robert, as I understand it, Voice User for Windows is actually a front end that sits on top of Microsoft Windows Sound System. And with this, I can navigate around Windows and actually run applications in Windows just by speaking to it?
That's right. Voice User comes with about 250 voice commands that gives you complete control of the Windows operating environment.
All right, give me an example of just doing some Windows navigation using voice.
Okay. Clock. Program manager. File manager.
So again, you can launch programs just by saying, here's what I want to do. You don't have to go figure out where the icon is.
That's right. You don't need to see the icon or anything.
How about working actually inside an application, like my scheduling program or something?
Okay, let me give you an example how you can set up an appointment. Program manager, schedule plus, set appointment, all afternoon, okay.
There it is. Pretty cool. Okay, how about in word processing, which most of us spend a lot of time doing? How could I use voice input in word processing?
Okay, let me show you how you can use the right word processor very simply. Program manager. Let's create a letter in there. Card file. Card file. Take a letter. Write.
So you just pulled out the address from the card file, got into write.
Okay. And it your letter. Maximize. Now I can just highlight some text over here.
So you can actually do some formatting stuff?
Mm-hmm. Larger. Larger. Smaller. Italic.
Okay, lastly, Robert, can you actually do voice annotation? I mean, record something to put inside a document?
Yes, that's one of the neat features of our product. You can annotate documents with voice commands.
All right, show me.
Program manager. Quick recorder, start recording. Hey, Stuart, check the wording in this document. Get back to me by Friday, and I'll let the client know. Thanks. Switch to write, quick recorder, paste annotation, paste annotation, and that pops
there
the annotation
cool.
into the document.
Okay, thank you. Today, we're going to look at voice input and voice output in a variety of PC applications, from word processing to games. Up until now, we've thought of voice as simply another way to move information in or out of a computer. But a new hardware software package called Wildfire actually uses voice communications to create a virtual electronic assistant. We visited photographer author Rick Smolin to see it in action.
These are the offices of Against All Odds, a production company across the bay from San Francisco, best known for a series of award-winning photography books and CDs. Rick Smolin, the traveling photographer who started the company with a series called A Day in the Life, just completed his latest endeavor called Passage to Vietnam. It's a collection of 200 photographs culled from over 200,000 taken by 70 photographers in the course of a week in Vietnam. It's a massive undertaking that puts him out of touch when he most needs to keep in touch. But Rick believes he has found a way to stay in contact with everyone through a digital assistant called Wildfire.
I will be.
Where?
Taking important calls.
Taking important calls where?
Work.
Work. For how many hours?
Four.
4 hours. Got it.
Wildfire is a computer-based electronic secretary that communicates in natural voice commands over a standard telephone line.
What I've been looking for years is the tireless personal assistant who always knows where I am, even when my plans are changing all day long, who can figure out who I want to talk to and who's going to waste my time, and actually act as an intelligent filter. And this new voicemail system, Wildfire, which has a really intriguing voice, I think of it as her, but I know it's a robot. Basically, if I tell her where I will be during the day, whether I'm in the car phone, whether I'm going to be in Vietnam next week for 5 days or whatever, she will be able to route my calls to me.
The key to keeping in touch is that no matter where you are, the system can find you. Rick's telephone number is the same wherever he is, and he can choose to have your call sent forward or not.
You don't have to have any idea whether I'm in my car, at home, in Vietnam. I will get the messages exactly the same, and I can respond to you exactly the same. So it sort of removes the place out of messages, and it just focuses on the person, which is all that I really care about. I just want to talk to you. I don't care where you happen to be.
Rick says he has become dependent on his human-like telephone assistant, although he realizes the relationship can be disconcerting to outsiders.
One of the funniest things that ever happened to me was I was at a payphone one day getting my messages, and I was saying, who's it from? File it. Throw it away. Give him a call. And the woman next to me at the next phone booth looked at me, and I realized that it sounded like I was an incredibly arrogant jerk talking to my secretary, and I tried to explain to her I was talking to a robot, and the woman just basically kind of walked away from me.
For the Computer Chronicles, I'm Giles Bateman.
There are several key issues in voice recognition. Can you speak continuously like a normal person, like I'm doing now, rather than say one word at a time? And do you have to train the system, or will it understand anyone? First, we'll look at a new product in continuous speech recognition from VPC Voice Processing Corporation. Here to help us do that is Jeff Hill. Jeff, in that Wildfire demo we just saw before, that was, in fact, using your VPC voice technology, wasn't it?
That's true.
And the point here is to be able to talk normally the way we do, rather than to adapt to the computer's language and say file, open, close, and that kind of stuff. Show me how you can use normal English sentences to do normal business operations
okay.
here.
Do I have any mail messages?
And when you say that, I hear the hard drive going. It's cranking up your email program without your saying open notes or whatever.
Detail view. Next message. What is on my schedule today?
So once again, rather than say open, Lotus Organizer, blah, 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 you said, I want to check my schedule.
Let me see next week, please. So that's an example of how you could talk to a computer much the same way you talk to a person.
All right, now you have an interesting database application here in which you can actually do a database query just by talking to it. So call that one up for me. I want to explain to our viewers we got some bug when you transferred your files over to your portable here. So we keep on seeing this warning window opening up. So don't let that get in your way.
Okay.
But show us the database query application.
Bring up customer database. Show me customers in New York. Look at all customers. Limit to customers with number greater than 20. Client database. View clients in Massachusetts. In California. California.
It's not like it in California much, is it? Let me ask you to move on to one more thing I want you to show me, which isn't real important but kind of fun. You can actually play chess using this voice input stuff, in which you just talk to the computer, say, I want to move my piece here or whatever. Show me how you do that.
All right. Well,
so it's Chess Master, I guess, is the game you got there.
Right. And we'll bring up the...
I see the window up there.
Right, and when we start talking chess, the chess program should come to the front. Pawn to king 4.
Pawn to king 4. Pawn to king
knight to King Bishop 3.
Why doesn't it like that number? Try again.
Knight to King's Bishop 3.
Knight to King Bishop 3. Knight to Queen Bishop 3.
You play the whole game. You talk to the computer. Computer talks back to you.
That's right.
Pretty cool. All right, Jeff, thanks a lot. Let's go over here now and join Bathsheba. It's very nice to be able to talk to your computer, of course, but ideally your computer should be able to talk to you also. One of the leading technologies in speech output is TrueVoice from Centigram Communications, and Bathsheba Malshin joins us now to demonstrate TrueVoice. Give me some examples of how I'd use the computer talking back to me, Bathsheba.
Well, you could get alarms and alerts, things like your printer is out of paper or your the toner is low, or you could get your email over the phone if you were not in the office, or you could have a fax read to you over the phone. Those are some of the applications.
All right, so give me an example of, and let's listen to the quality of the speech output here.
Okay.
And tell me what you're doing.
I'm just going to type in something simple, like welcome to Computer Chronicles.
You're going to replace me with a computer, huh? That's what you're saying.
Sure.
Welcome to Computer Chronicles. Welcome to Computer Chronicles.
Okay, now frankly, I mean, 10 years ago, my Apple II could do that. I mean, so what's the big deal about using this technology now? What else can you do?
Well, we can do a number of things. One of the things is we now have emotion in our speech, so that if someone wants to say something with great affect, mm-hmm. such as, get out of here right now, in the past, the computer would just say, get out of here right now, but now...
So you add an exclamation mark and...
Mm-hmm.
Get out of here right now. Get out of here right now.
So it knows mm-hmm. exclamation, get a little excited, huh?
Yes.
Now, you can also do this in lots of different languages, which is one nice feature, I guess, in today's global economy world. Show mm-hmm. me that part of it.
Sure. Do something simple, like...
Okay, so you're typing in French, you're saying it's going to know, hey, this is French, I better use French pronunciation rules?
Yes.
And how many other languages can you do?
Well, let me show you. We can do German, Italian, Spanish, English, and French.
So it has all the rules of those five languages sitting in it.
Yes.
Now, it also does something interesting you call using American English, because we often use foreign words, but we don't pronounce them according to the mm-hmm. foreign rules. Show mm-hmm. me an example of that.
Sure. In the English language, very little is actually bona fide English. So if you look at some of our common words, especially foods, you'll see.
A couple of Japanese words.
Sure. Let's see, some nice wine, something to go with that wine.
A couple of French words.
Gee, let's try a nice Hebrew word and play these.
Sushi, sashimi, tofu. Bordeaux, hors d'oeuvres, chiclets.
So it knows, hey, I want to do this in American English, not in the original native language in the context you're in.
Right.
Okay, now one other thing you do which is very interesting is the kind of intelligence you have. One of the problems, if we write normally, we use lots of abbreviations and shorthands mm-hmm. and things that most speech output systems don't understand, and they read us a bunch of gobbledygook.
Mm-hmm.
Show me how you would apply that intelligence.
Okay, well... First of all, when people normally get an email message, there is
a lot of junk in it.
Very messy header. And you can take a look at, besides having a messy header, there are lots and lots of different abbreviations. And people are pretty sloppy about the way that they construct an email message.
So that message is designed to fool any text-to-speech system, huh?
Right. So we have an intelligent preprocessor that...
Start of message. From Daniel. Date, Friday, 30 September 94 at 1750 PDT. Subject, email reader demo. As described on pages 230 to 235 of the book, they will go 1/2 mile on their 16-foot sloop to buy 12 dozen apples, 102-inch nails, and 3 heaping gallons of ice cream from the gal at the 50,000
square
feet. Okay,
so at the top we're seeing, in the way it was originally written, at the bottom we're seeing its intelligent interpretation of all those peculiar little signs and symbols.
Yes.
And again, this could be reading me my voicemail over the phone, which is where I want it to apply that intelligence,
yes.
like a human would.
Yes.
All right, thanks a lot. There are several major players in this voice recognition field we've been talking about, among them IBM, Kurzweil, Dragon Systems. Another one of the leaders in the field is Philips. They've been working on every executive's dream, a computerized dictation system.
Speech recognition is not a new idea, nor is the technology a recent discovery. What is new is a system capable of recognizing continuous speech, the natural way humans read and talk at normal speed. In the past, users had to slow down and pause between words like this, making speech input tedious and artificial, or the vocabulary was severely limited. But Philips claims it has solved these problems using an acoustic model based on a sample of the speaker's voice and a more sophisticated language model.
With our system, you can speak like I speak now and it still will get recognized. Then the second characteristic of our system is that we do it for large vocabularies, because there are other systems that do continuous speech, but then you only can have 150 or 500 words. And we have large vocabularies, and we are at the moment working with between 30 and 50,000 words, and it will be increasing in the near future as well. The third main characteristic of our system is that it's free-form speech, so that you basically, within a certain context, can say whatever you like.
After 40 to 50 minutes of user training, the Philips speech processor will accept continuous input within the subject area specified. After dictation, the material is ready for editing like any other word processing document. The system makes its best guess based on the probability and context. Sometimes it makes mistakes, but Philips believes it is better to correct errors later than to interrupt a speaker's train of thought. Equally important is the system's ability to work in real-life surroundings.
Many speech vendors have been focusing on purely technology, and then people were put in a soundproof room, and people were just starting to talk, and then they were surprised that in real-life situations, suddenly the results were so much poorer than in the laboratory situation. What we did, since we have 40 years of speech experience with dictation, we took real-life data and tuned our systems onto that, because where you would expect that speech recognition is a real science, all the algorithms behind it and the technology is pure science, but then you have to start tuning, like with a car, to really make it for optimal use.
For the Computer Chronicles, I'm Giles Bateman.
As I mentioned earlier, Dragon Systems is one of the leading innovators in the field of voice recognition. Their product is Dragon Dictate for Windows, and here to show it to us is Frank McGrath, their director of engineering. Frank, we're kind of in dictation mode right now, so I want you to show me Dragon Dictate for Windows in WordPerfect, for example, where I'd use it to create a letter.
All right. Please wake up. Bring up WordPerfect. Dictate mode. Begin document. Dragon Dictate, circle R, for Windows. New paragraph. DDWin combines both, scratch that, font bold, both, font bold, large vocabulary dictation with command and control capabilities, period. New paragraph. DDWin runs on normal hardware. Oops. Choose two. Period. This demonstration is using generic 46 laptop with a built-in sound system. Period. Command mode. Top of document. Select line. Layout. Font. Font size. Move down. Faster. Faster. Stop. Bold, italic, color, space bar, mouse lower right, slower, stop, button click, OK, home key, insert logo, go to sleep.
Pretty cool. OK. I want to ask you to move now into the spreadsheet environment, because this is very nice also. You can actually enter data and manage a spreadsheet using Dragon Dictate. Pull up Excel for me.
OK. Please wake up. Bring up Excel. Cell edit, Steve Squires. Cell OK. Format, column, auto fit selection. Cell right, 13 October. Cell right, 14.7. Next row, Betsy Steele. Cell right, 13 January, sell right, 32.6. Sell okay. Go to sleep.
All right, very nice. One other thing I want you to show me. You have a nice feature here where you can check in any particular environment what words are available that the system will understand. Show that to me.
At any point, I can say, what can I say? Please wake up. What can I say? Go to sleep. And these are the words active in Excel. And if I go to the bottom, please wake up. Page down. Go to sleep. These are the words that we automatically track that our system figures out for you.
That's great. Frank, thank you very much. As I mentioned earlier, one of the problems with good speech recognition systems is you have to train them, and they don't work with any user. That's the problem the folks at Kurzweil have tried to solve with their new product, Kurzweil Voice for Windows. Harley Rosnow is here to show us how that works. Hi, Harley. Okay, I want you to show us, first of all, how you use the system and how you would dictate a letter using the Kurzweil system. Then I want to take over and try it myself and see if it will really work with me, even though I've never trained it.
Sure thing.
So do a letter in WordPerfect for us.
Listen to me. Open WordPerfect. Letterhead. Today's date. New paragraph. Mom's address. New paragraph. Dear Mom. Initial cap that, comma, new paragraph. I hope everything is going well with you and Dad. Period. Standard apology. Answering machine excuse.
You're mean.
Delete that. I have been very busy showing the latest release of our new product, Kurzweil Voice, uppercase that, for Windows, initial cap that, period. Let me tell you about it, colon. New paragraph. Voice info. New paragraph. Standard mom closing. Sign it. Stop listening.
Pretty clever. All right, can you set it up so that I could try this now? And it obviously knows you. You've done this many, many times, but I've never used the system before. So you have to kind of just tell it, here's a new user, here's his name, it's a man, not a woman.
That's right. Yeah, I'm just going to set it up now. I'll load the voice profile that we just created for you.
So you set up a sort of blank profile for me and given it my name, et cetera?
That's right. The only thing it knows is that you're male. The way the system works is that you can start using the system immediately and you get productive work out of it. As you correct any recognition errors which might occur, it then adapts to your voice on an ongoing basis. After you've used the system for a while and you've grown accustomed to it, you can then go through an enrollment process at a time of your choosing. It only records your voice for about 20 minutes, and then what it does is it phonetically analyzes those words and it boosts the accuracy for the entire vocabulary for your voice.
So it's almost got my sort of blank page in there called Stuart.
That's right, it's almost loaded. It's loaded now. I'll get you started, okay? Open WordPerfect.
Open WordPerfect.
This
is a test of how well the system works with a new user. Stop listening. Very impressive. Okay, it actually worked. Thank you very much. All right, that's our look at talking computers. Remember, if you have any questions about anything you've seen on today's show, or if you'd like to suggest topics for future programs, you can talk to us online on the Computers on Television forum on CompuServe. The command is Go Chronicles. Thanks for joining us. I'm Stuart Chaffee. See you here next time on the Computer Chronicles.